What do you mean by that? ரூம் போட்டு யோசிப்பாங்க போல் இருக்கு. மேரேஜ் எ கான்ட்ராக்ட் பேஸ்ட் ஆன் லவ் அண்ட் அஃபெக்ஷன். கோர்ஸ் சி ஷீ திங்க்ஸ் வெரி ஃபார் அவே நோ இட்ஸ் குட் யார் ஸ்டாச்சுரி பாடிஸ் அண்ட் முனிசிபல் பாடிஸ் லோக்கல் பாடிஸ் கேனாட் என்டர் இன் டு அ கான்ட்ராக்ட் விச் ஆர் நாட் விதின் தேர் ஸ்டாச்சுரி பவர்ஸ் ஆர் அல்ட்ராவேர்ஸ் தேர் இஸ் அ டெக்னிக்கல் வேர்ட் ஆன் தட் விச் தே ஆர் நாட் எம்பவர்ட் பை தேர் பை லாஸ் ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் எ கம்பெனி கார்பரேஷன் ஆர் ஈவன் சப்போஸ் சென்னை கார்பரேஷன் தே கெனாட் என்டர் இன் டு அ கான்ட்ராக்ட் ஜஸ்ட் லைக் தட் இஃப் இட் இஸ் நாட் ப்ரொவைடட் அண்ட் அப்ரூவ்டு பை தி bylaws of the corporation. So this is statutory body is also an alien, sorry, an entity, a separate entity which can enter into contracts. For example, Tamil Nadu electricity boards call for contracts, tenders. That means Tamil Nadu electricity board chairman is approved to enter into contracts. And if the contract for a particular item is not available or not allowed by the bylaws of that corporation or that board, then they are not supposed to make the contract. Understand? So she is laughing. So she has got any point to ask? Very good, Ma. Tell me. One, two, three. Third point about. Tell me. You make the class in a very light mood, huh? All the time. Good. Tell me. Don't do these things, guys. Fraudulently doing something for necessaries, your property is liable, not you. Food, clothing, necessaries of life. your father will be caught hold of. That's all. What to do? It's something very light, interesting. You boys don't get such questions, huh? Is your doubt clear? That person, that's all. He doesn't have any. Don't try to do all those things, huh? Taranabhan, have 1,000 rupees worth of food. With all your minor friends. Nowadays they don't have this. No? That also. Okay. Now, we'll have a quick summary on the points what we have gone through. Summary, rules and agreement registered with minor. Basically, it is void ab initio. Any agreement with a minor is void. No estoppels against a minor. No damage can be claimed from the minor for deceit or what she asked. Okay, so no damages or anything can be claimed from the minor. No ratification on attaining majority. Supplier entitled for reimbursement for supply of necessaries. Minor as a partner is only entitled for the benefits of the business or for himself. Minor as agent, commission benefits he is entitled to. Anything that is related to a minor for his benefits, it will be on his favor. Okay. So, minor as an insolvent, not possible. Okay. You can do anything till the time you become a major. Minor can sign negotiable instruments only for the benefits. Now we can see lot of kids opening bank accounts. Anyone has any got any idea? Anyone has got as a minor has got a bank account? Now you don't go to Saravadhan, okay? Tell me. So who signs on your behalf? You sign? School. You have a bank account in some bank and the school has got the authority to sign. Okay. Who else is having bank account? You are a minor? Minor? Minor or major? Minor. Okay, who signs? Who signs for your account? You sign. Countersigned by your. No, 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 no. Yeah, check. Okay. No, only he can sign. Not you. That's what I'm telling, no? Your sign has to be attested by him. Minor can enter into beneficial contracts for themselves. Contract on minors by parents and guardians? Not possible. Okay? Note, minor has the liberty to lie. He can sue a person or his guardian for cheating him or her. Don't try to do all those things, huh? A person with sound mind, a person is of unsound mind if he, at the time of contract, is capable of understanding it and is for forming the judgment of it on the effects of his interest, which we discussed. Persons of unsound mind, example for idiots, example for lunatics and drunken or intoxicated. Drug addicts are all intoxicated, so they are not supposed to get into any contracts. Disqualified by law to which they are subject, alien enemy or foreigners, foreign diplomats, convicts, insolvents after discharge of all debts can contract. Important point here, no? In the summary you get something new. Insolvents, after discharge of all the debts, they can enter into contract. A person who is insolvent, he is paying off all his liabilities. Now he becomes a fresh person. The insolvent can become a normal person. So after that, he can enter into contract. The companies, if the memorandum and articles of association by the bylaws of the company allows that to enter into contract. Okay. Now, we will go to the unit 4. You have got any doubt till now? It's too much for the day. Yes, no, yes, am I going very fast? You say yes, no, any points to ask, any points to clarify? See, friends, I am not, this subject is, as I told you in the previous class, it's a sort of a static subject, it's not undergoing dynamic changes, right? The first point itself we saw, it is a private law. It is applicable to those persons who are entering into contract, right? So here, our institute material is very good, okay, very informative, very detailed, and with enough number of points. My quotations and references are more from institute materials plus the other books which I am going through. Okay. So, go through the institute materials and you can, the institute has got some questions in the back with answers. Please try out those questions which has got answers given. There are some centers or academies which I have seen. They will give you a big bunch of, big book of question bank. Many questions will be wrong. Answers will be equally wrong. So, and you will get confused which part of the question you have to answer. Please spend your time in trying out the questions which you have answers. Don't try anything without answers. That is important. Okay. We'll go to the next, or we'll close the day. Close the day. Don't get it. Go to the next. Very good. Very enthusiastic. So that we can hear more Manya's doubts. We can go more. I will be happy to go. See, this guy is, no? Yes. Feeling bored? Too much for the day. Anyway, you are not talking. Good. We'll have a small run through of the points, then we'll close. Another 5 minutes. There's something called free consent. For a valid contract, we have seen the points of agreement, then capacity to contract. Now comes free consent. When two or more persons have consented on the same thing with the same mind, is called consensus ad item. Free consent has to have consensus ad item, and it should not be having any of these following aspects: coercion, undue influence, fraud, misrepresentation, and mistake. Okay? A contract cannot arise. See, these are the headings which are going to be discussed under the unit free consent. Okay? So, we'll have these things in detail. So, just for the main point, a contract cannot arise in the absence of a free consent. See, now we have seen the conditions for consideration can be past, present, future. There is no quantum of consideration that is being fixed, adequacy of consideration, all those aspects we saw in consideration. Now coming to this aspect, fix your mind only for consent, free consent. It is not. So under this, five top headings: coercion, undue influence, fraud, misrepresentation, and mistake. The first four, when there is a contract under the first four, it is a voidable contract. I will read out that point to note, which I have given it in red. When the consent is not free due to mistake or the fact, due to mistake of the fact, we will see the examples once we go into the points. The agreement is void. But in all the other cases, the contract is voidable at the option of the parties whose consent was obtained by coercion, undue influence, fraud, or misrepresentation. See, these are the four technical jargons which will be used in this chapter, in this unit. Coercion is nothing but force. We'll see it in detail. Undue influence also. Those are those four types, and coercion, undue influence, fraud, or misrepresentation, the contract is voidable. Just have that in the mind. The aspect of the contract where there is a mistake, the agreement is void. It doesn't go to the contract stage itself. It becomes void. Okay. Now, coercion. Section 15, it means committing or threatening to commit any act forbidden by the Indian Penal Code. We will see the examples. Just note down these points, then we will see the example. Unlawful detention or threatening to detain of the property of a person to the prejudice of any person to enter into an agreement with an intention of causing any person to enter into an agreement. Example, X says to Y, I shall kill your son if you do not sell your car to me for ₹50,000. Right? Y says, please don't kill my son, I shall sell my car to you for ₹50,000. Okay, so there is an offer, there is an acceptance, forced acceptance, otherwise coercion. Okay, so by this example, we can understand the definition better. Okay, here the contract is made under coercion and hence voidable at the option of Y. Y is the aggrieved party. He is put into force. In this example, Y later on can say, yes, fine, no problem. Anyway, my car was to sell, sold at 30,000. I am getting 50,000. I am happy. I have sold it. Something like that. So that is voidable. Means at the option of the person who is aggrieved, who is forced, then the contract, that is why we call it as a contract which is voidable. Voidable contract, what was the definition? Just go to the point and tell me. What is voidable contract? Read it out fully. Read it out exactly as per the words what we talked. Okay? Means, here in this case, X cannot say it is accepted by me, so it is a valid contract. Y is the person who is aggrieved, who is put into force, who is put into coercion. Coercion is the technical jargon. So, who is put into coercion, he is the aggrieved party, and if he accepts the contract, it becomes a valid contract. Okay? Is it clear? Undue influence. A contract is made by undue influence if there subsists a relationship such that one party is in a position to dominate or influence the will of the other and takes unfair advantage to induce the other party to enter into an agreement. The person, what is your name? What is your name? Arun. You can go out of the class. Please go out of the class. Please. Please go out of the class, I am telling you. Keep your notebook here and go. This is called undue influence. Guy, this is called undue influence. Right? As a teacher, I can influence that boy. He says, he's blinking. Oh God, what is he doing? Is he going mad? This is called undue influence. Right? A contract which is made by undue influence, and if, don't make it as a voidable contract and walk out, huh? Okay, if there subsists a relationship such that one party is in a position to dominate or influence the other with an intention to take advantage to induce the other party to enter into an agreement. Okay? Example. Yes, madam, tell me. I was worried. Why there is no question? Tell me. Blackmailing never comes under this mode. That will come under coercion. No, I told you, no. That is sort of a coercion. That's what the first example was there. No? I will kill your son if you don't give your car for 50,000 rupees. Okay. So you mean to say that the relationship continues, is it? No, you can keep dominating your, for example, your dad. Dad, you get me that, otherwise I will not have food. Otherwise I will not go to the class. Something like that. Poor dad, he will give that and he will pay for that. And no, if you go there and ask questions, he will send you here. Right? So, undue influence, you need to have a relationship. There is a teacher-student relationship. There is a father-son or daughter relationship. And undue influence is applicable only when there is a relationship wherein I can dominate the other person. Okay, the example what Manya is asking is, no, I have done some mistake or something wrong, and she knows that fact. She keeps telling, guy, please do like this, otherwise I will tell. Something like that. You have to tell me. You are asking a question, the other students have to tell me. I just now told you. Coercion? It's coercion. Between what? Nahi, that is what I am going to tell you. You are telling about a contract or you are telling, no, I'll commit suicide if you are not getting into a contract with that person. Something like that. That's what you are asking. Right? So there is a fiduciary relationship between you and your father. Then your father budges just for that purpose. That is called undue influence because there is a relationship. Normally, you tell somebody, I'll do this, I will commit suicide if you don't sign this contract or something like that. There is a coercion. Okay? We'll go to the points where there is a. Between coercion and undue influence, there are quite a few differences which we'll be discussing. A father can influence his son and dominate his decision. A lawyer can influence his client and make him finalize a contract. He has got a fiduciary relationship. A trustee can dominate on a beneficiary. An old age person suffering from ill health, distress, is unduly influenced by the service provider. For example, no, you go to an old age home. Okay, people they need a lot of help for going to the hospital or something like that. Okay, the owner says, no, the old age running person, a service provider, he says, no, you have to pay 500 rupees to take a call taxi, something like that. So he'll be having no other option than to pay it. So there is a relationship here between the service provider and the beneficiary or the person who is there. So due to illness, he is having no other alternative than to pay the money. Okay, we know all these things, no, that gets that happens in the central station or airport and all those places. You come in the midnight, you never get a train nor a bus. So our auto guys are there. Right? For going from central, my house is in Edmore. One way he was asking me 200 rupees from central to Edmore in the night. When I was coming with my parents, he can say anything, no. No, people are known for that. Okay, so teacher on a student. Okay, so with these, we'll close the day's class up to undue influence. Okay, so till now, any points? So next class, I think it's next Thursday. So probably I will try and squeeze in some more classes for you so that we'll try and finish our portions. Okay. So, till now, any points, any doubts? Is the class going too heavy or too slow, too fast? Something to be improved to our no, fiduciary relationship properly? Everybody is understanding, or no? Any? I want everybody to be interactive. So only few are interactive. Of course, money is most. These are doubts. Okay? Thank you.